Questão. Is it working? Working. Let's see if this is working. Hello. Seems that it's working. Yeah, it's working. Hello? I'm trying to do a lot of things at the same time, so I don't know what I'm doing right now. I'm broadcasting live to this to the YouTube channel. Let's see if I can put on Instagram too. Not sure if this is going to work, but let's try. Let's try. Think I'm live now on Instagram too. Yeah, hello. Hello, does it work? Yes. Hello, hello. Hello. Oh, I forgot one thing. Wait for me. I forgot one thing. Very important thing. I'm coming. Now I'm back. Let's see if this is someone is here watching me or not. This is the first time I'm doing this in both Instagram and on the YouTube channel. So you can go to the YouTube channel if you want. You will see me there live too. I think you see me there in the YouTube channel. So let's see if I can watch myself also on Instagram. I don't know how to do it on this. Let's see if I can. Does anyone knows how to put this on Instagram so I can see myself there? Because I'm trying to watch myself on Instagram on the computer, and then well, try to answer the questions on Instagram. Hola, hola. Bienvenidos. Let's see. Let's see if I can see myself. If I change my profile to my other account, no, I can't do it. Oh my God, how to do this? How to do this? Explore Reels message notifications profile. Can I watch myself live? It's crazy. Does anybody knows how to see yourself in on Instagram? This is, I don't know how to do it. What? Doesn't matter. Let's try. I will go to the Instagram account there, and I will try to see what you have said, what you have told me there, and maybe we can do this in a better way sometimes. Let me see. Let me see. Want you to see my account. Yeah, you can't see it now. Let's try. I'm not a robot, and this is a car, this is a car, and this is a car. No more. Oh yes, that one. Verify. Next. Yeah. Yes, I'm here. I'm live. Right, I hope you can still hear me. Can you hear me on YouTube? Right, perfect. I think this is working perfectly right now. Not perfectly, but more or less. Let's see if I can do something. Hello, and welcome to this crazy thing I'm trying to do here. Let's see if I can. Yes. All right. Perfect. Perfect. Perfect, perfect. All right. Well, before we do something else, and we'll paint in Borgor today. But before we do it, I have a unboxing. But the unboxing is one of the most boring unboxings that I have. So I will explain a little bit what this unboxing is about. Because I think a lot of people are not very interested in these kind of things, but I will try to convince you that this is important. So let me show you right now this. Let me show you this one. I'm not sure if you can see. This is a box. I will try to open the let's see what is inside. I hope I don't broke it because this is one of the most expensive things that yes. Going to kill me right now. This is what I have here. What I have here is something that I have been waiting for a long time, and is a very, very important part of my job. Not my day job, but Art Fabula job. Is a safety gloves, chemical safety gloves, and is the only thing that works with thinner. Yes, I know you can tell me what you want, but with the health, this is what I'm going to put my money on. I don't going to play with my health, especially if I'm in this small studio with bad fumes and everything. This one is the Alpha Tech. Not sure if you can see it there. Alpha Tech unsealed gloves for thinners. Let me show you to the those ones. So these things works perfectly. It's the only thing that works with thinner. There isn't anything at all that works with thinner when I'm doing the rubbing thing. I have been using those nitrile gloves before when painting. And it's not a big problem when painting, because, well, the paint goes on the toy itself. It not goes on my hand too much when I'm painting. But when I'm when yeah, the security is the most important thing. But when I'm using the when I'm making this rubbing thing with well, you know what I'm doing. If you have seen the videos before, I used to paint in one color and then with a little bit of thinner and paper, something like that, I take the paint off the toy. That process is very bad for the skin in the head. And maybe if you do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 10 times, it doesn't matter too much. But if you do as often as I do, for example, this I have in the pre-orders of the Borgor, I made 45 Borgors. And I did exactly the same thing for all the 45 Borgors, then we have a big problem. My hands can get too much thing, and I'm going to destroy my hands. And I'm very that kind of things. The thinner is very, very, very dangerous. I will show you a thing. This is the thinner I'm using. This one of those, the Hikari thinner. This. And if you read the safety sheet for this one, you will see that you need to use gloves. And it doesn't matter what kind of thing of thinner do you use, you need to use gloves. But what people doesn't know is that you can't use whatever gloves you want. You need to read these security, safety, elevator safety data sheet. And there they told you which kind of gloves works. My wife works with these kind of things. She works for the security in a lab, in a medicine company. So she knows a lot of things about security and the injuries you can get if you don't follow the security thing. So this is what the factory of the thinner recommends. These what this. Let me try. I'm not sure if this is my, I hope it's my size. Let's see if this is my size. This is going to be, I can use it a few hours. Some days going to broke. And can't open this. And it's okay that it broke. It's made to use a few times and then buy a new one. But you can use it around, I think it's 500 hours if you are using constantly, as of every time. But I can use it more than 500 hours. I don't need so many times, but 500 hours is too much. Let me show you if I can open it. How do you open this thing? Yes. One of the most important things with these gloves is not put it on water. You can't use water on this. If you use water, if it takes a little bit of water on it, then you destroy the usability of this completely. So you need to be very, very careful with the water. And it's very, very funny that you can destroy gloves with water, and then you can use them with thinner. But this is because this has some kind of film around that protect your hands with thinner from the thinner. So this is very important. This is I have well a pair of those. I'm not sure I'm going to need a pair because I can hold one toy with one hand and then the other I can use with the gloves and try to rub it. It's not so flexible, and you understand why it's not so flexible. These kind of gloves are very thick and they are used, well, they use them for this. So those gloves that you see, these gloves that you see, well, I can use my left hand when this is broken, and I can use my right hand, so I can alternate when using them. So I hope it gives me around 1,000 hours or more of usability. So this is the gloves I bought, important part of the security, together with everything else that I have. So those one, very expensive. And when I say very expensive, I mean it. This is a lab, a professional globe. This is not at users, at normal globes. This cost, well, around $70 or something like that. It's very, very, very expensive. So, well, I'm not sure if I recommend, but I recommend be careful with the security. So the security is always first. And I'm using a lot of dangerous products here. So I think it's better to be careful. Now, well, they are not so, I mean, they are a little bit stiff and very hard, but I don't have any problem. I can take a toy with my hands. It's not so delicate. It's not so easy. But for the usability that I'm going to to have for the my needs, I think is more than enough. Because I will use often I will use the right hand, and then I will put the toy in my left hand, and then just with some kind of paper or something like that, I will try to rub it. So I think it works. It's not so, look at this, it's not so, well, fit, maybe a little bit big for me. It's a number nine. I usually use the nine also. So maybe size smaller could be a bra, could be good. But it doesn't matter. I think they will be softer after a while. I hope so. But yes, it works. It works for me. It seems like I'm in space. So perfect. Now they are here. It took more than 2 weeks to get them here from Sweden. I bought them from Sweden, so I don't know why it took so much time to make. Yes. Now what we are going to do. Let's paint the last two borgors that I have here, and I have a head here that needs to be painted, the eyes and the tongue and the teeth, and then I will put a little bit of shadows in the legs, and then I will paint the arms here also, the eyes of the hands in red, and put shadows. So I think I will begin with maybe this one. I think so. Yes, what I am going to use to put the paint on, I think I will use some kind of plastic thing. I should use a palette or something like that, but I don't want a palette. I will use this. This is what I'm going to use, and it works for me. Is the label, you know, stickers, label for shipping. This is what I'm going to use. Yeah, for paint. I will put here, and then I will use what. And I have this thing here, and you can see, but this is my, if you are on YouTube, you will see my vortex also. Maybe you can hear, and it works perfectly. The vortex is to, to mix the so I think it's okay. I have a little bit of water here. And I'm going to use those. These are my favorite brushes, those ones. I hope you can see it there. It's very difficult to see. They are the Tamiya. No, this is not Tamiya. This is Mr. Hobby, I think. ESI Creos, round two, number two, and number four. I hope you can see them. Those are very good. Those are my favorite. They are some kind of gummy handle here, and then some kind of it keeps their form. So I like it. I like them very much. I will use the big one, the number four, for the toy, for this toy. So let's see what I can do. A little bit stiff here, but it works. Where is my paper? So yes, the reception of Borgor has been very good. I've been very happy about how it became this toy. It's incredible how many people bought the Borgor, the pre-orders. I'm very 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 pleased with the results. So what I'm doing right now is I need a pause. I need a little bit of time after I send all these toys, because it's taking a lot of time to paint every one of those. And I've paint 40 of those toys, 45 of those toys is crazy. It's crazy. But people are very happy with those. And I'm very happy that people are happy. So that's what's keeping me continue making those toys and painting them. It's very, very, well, it's good to hear that people like what I'm doing. Those vinyl toys I'm making are very pleased. And I'm not making toys. This is something that I would like to discuss, because my toys have different meanings, different kind of, how do I say, they are both classical and not classical. So I have the classical Sofubi toy that is a gecko one. This is a real classical gecko toy. You can move it around, you can put arms and the head and move it how you want. You can call it a classical Sofubi toy. And then I have this kind of Sofubi vinyl toy that I have here. You can move it a little bit, but it's not designed to play with it. It's just more, not a statue, because you can move the head a little bit and the arms a little bit, but you can't, and it's not designed to play as much as Gecko one with it. So I hope people don't get, don't get the wrong idea with this toy. The people that got this toy in their hands are very, very happy. They knew that it was big, but that they didn't knew that it was so big. Yeah, that's the funny part. So I'm painting the toy. I'm painting the toy in a few steps. I usually paint the tongue, and then I paint the eyes first, one layer, and then a second layer, and maybe a third layer. It depends how it seems, because this paint, this is an acrylic paint. They need a few layers on top of each other, so you can, you can get a good result. So now I have the tongue here, and now I'm going to get the second layer on the first toy that I paint here, that I painted. I'm not sure if there are people watching on YouTube. I don't think there are people watching on YouTube. Let's see if there are people. No, nobody's watching, but it doesn't matter. I will put this streaming online for you to see later. So now I'm painting the second layer for this toy. I tried to paint this before with another kind of paint, with the thinner paints, with the Hecari toy paints. And those are very difficult to manage. Those paints are incredible. They are not made for brushes, so I had a lot of problems painting. So I jumped into acrylic for the details of Borgor before shipping everything. So this is the paint I'm using right now. Yeah, thank you very much. Thank you. I hope you can hear me from on YouTube. This is the first time doing anything. Well, you can ask me questions if you have, both on YouTube and on Instagram. I see both of them, and so I know what you're doing. So the second layer. And you are going to see the difference, and I'm going to show you here. It begins to get, you begin to see the difference here, and I will show you there. Let's see on Instagram. Now I'm going to put the second layer on the second toy. A little bit more of water. After when I'm done with Borgor, sending those last pre-orders this week, I will concentrate all my time on making more gecko bones. I have a lot of gecko bones prepared, so I need to paint, and I will do also a collaboration with a Mexican artist that is waiting for me for a few months now, a few weeks. He has a lot of patience, so I'm very happy. And I wanted to paint a few of his toys, and they are waiting for me there. But soon enough. So the second one, I think I will paint this one too, the arms. Oh, this is a little bit of difficult process because I don't want too much paint on it, and I can see here with the lights. Big problem. Let's see if I can do it. Yeah. Yes. Good. Not so bad. Not so bad. I have another one. I have four of these, so I need to paint four of this. Oh, you can hear me. How did you arrive at this color for the first colorway? Do you mean how do I how why well for this one, is a prototype. That one. I'm not sure how I did it. I mean, I remember that I got the parts, all the parts for Borgor. And then I just thought that the creation, the original version of Borgor was green in my head. So I thought that this toy should be green from the beginning for the original one. I just used two different greens on it. I chose a darker one and a more light one. And then I played with this contrast. For example, you can see, you can see the two colors. I hope you can see the two colors here. And then, the other parts, I think I thought that the green and the red, the green, orange, and the green, I mean, yellow and red, that's what I mean, worked very, very well with the toy, as you see here. So, yeah, it worked very well. So I don't know. I thought I just painted it in a few colors that I thought it could work, and then I just did it. I have three colors in mind right now. I will come up with 300 more. That's what it how it is. I know how this thing's going. It's the same with the gecko one. I sit and paint and paint and paint, and sometimes I have paints schemes in my head. And sometimes it's just improvised, and often they work very well. So that's how it is with the toys. This is how it works with these things. When you are painting, when you have been painting a long time, when you have been working a long time, a lot of time with toys. And when you have seen, when you have a collection, you know how it works. You know what colors match with each other, and how to mix and match the colors. And there are typical colors, and that works also, that everyone uses in their toys, that people like, and then just use them too, and combine them in the best possible way. That's what I want, and I'm continuing studying. This is something that I usually do. I watch other toys, I watch other people, other artists painting toys, and their paint mix, and I use those kind of paints in my paint schemes, also in my toys. And everyone should do that. Why not? They copy from the classics, so you copy from them. Yeah, thank you. So it's not copying, it's just using the normal color scheme, classical color scheme of the toys. How many people are here? Not so many. It doesn't matter. Need to paint. So I have the four arms now. And then and now I'm going to put the third layer on the tongue of Borgor. I think I made two of one on one of the other. But I will continue. I will put a third. Hello, welcome everyone. How is everyone doing? It's too hot here right now. I should have opened the window. But the problem with this is this hot inside this warm here inside the room. The studio, not outside. Outside is cold. It's very, very cold. It's like winter, something like that. But here inside is too warm. So the neighbors, or I don't know what they are doing. Let's see. Paint. I've been thinking about thinking a lot about what I consider myself, and this is something that I not sure if I'm in the same place that other people that make art toys, because I don't know if I'm how to say well I made a video about this on internet on YouTube about to be an artist or not to be an artist, to call me an artist or not. And I told in this video that I'm not an artist. That's not what I am. And a lot of people consider me an artist because I create things, I design things, I paint things. And well, yes, that's what it is. But I consider myself as some kind of designer, some kind of creator, but not a content creator, but a more a creator of illusions, of something that people like, of happiness, a creator of happiness, yeah. Because of people, I create happiness for the people. People like the toys, and people are happy with the toys. So that's what's making me. But the discussion, the problem, and this is a very deep discussion, is that a lot of people consider themselves as well, artist, and it's okay. I don't have any problems about what people consider themselves, but the problem I have is the overvalue of a few pieces here and there, and that's something that I'm not sure if I like it or not. I understand the time, I understand the price that takes to make one of these toys. I understand because I'm doing it myself. This is not a cheap business at all. This is a very expensive product. This is what it is. And you are painting it by hand, as I'm doing, and you are making the toy with your own hands, and it's your idea and everything, and you're making, you're selling everything yourself, all these kind of things. So of course you need to reflect these. You need to mirror this time and this effort in the price of the toys. So I'm not saying that they should be cheap or cheaper. Oh, cheap. I'm saying that they should be cheaper, a few of those, not everyone. In the beginning, I put the prices a little bit too high, for example, A. Other people reacted to it. I was a nobody. I'm still a nobody. And then I tried to create a toy. And then I thought, well, those toys are selling for more than $100. And so I should put this price to for my toy. And well, what's the problem? Well, the problem was that I have only 100 followers on Instagram. Nobody knew about me. Nobody knew about my toys and what I did, and who would buy my toys, especially at $100. They didn't see the value because I wasn't a famous person. So yeah, that was the problem. With the time, they see the value in my toys. And it's not that I'm putting higher prices for my toys with the time. Of course, I need to raise the price a little bit because the cost is going up, not going down. And to produce this toy each year, it costs a lot of money. And the raw materials in Japan, for example, are getting higher prices. And the factories in Japan and getting also higher prices. Something that I think is perfectly and good for everyone. They should be get more money for the work, but also the money needs to be well come from somewhere, and. If I raise the price a little bit, then a little bit of money comes from the people that buy the toys, and a little bit of money comes from my pocket because I will never ever high the price to the original price they ask me. So I'm selling this not right now because I think I already paid for the production of this toy. But I'm selling those. No, I'm not in plus right now. but I'm selling those toys cheaper than it cost me to produce. That's what it is. Especially if you count the paint, if you count the amount of work that this toy is taking me. It's incredible. So I'm painting everything by hand, and it takes a lot of time to paint. So I don't know what to do. But I think the prices should be a little bit lower, especially people that are selling too expensive for hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of dollars. I think it's okay to put a high price, but I think it should be some kind of max price, accept price, especially resellers. Resellers, that's I don't want to go there. That's the worst part. The worst part is our resellers. And I don't mean resellers like Mandarake or people that sells my toys. I don't mean that those one. Those one are necessary. Those one I have no problem. The galleries, the shops, I don't have any problems with that. The only problems that I have are the people that applies to the lottery, or buy one, two, three, four, five toys, and then immediately they sell them for a higher price to, for example, Mandarake or other, or online on eBay. Those are the people I have problems with. Those are the people that I don't, well, don't, not that I don't like, but yeah, I don't like them. The resellers. So in Japan, it's a big problem because, for example, I have seen my toys in a few auctions websites in Japan immediately after releasing. So I don't know who it is. But I'm creating some kind of list of people that they are not going to get my toys because of that, because they are trying just to sell the toys. So, yeah. And another thing, another problem that I have. And that's my opinion here, are the people that are painting the toys, for example, I create. repainting those. The repainting of the toys, well, I don't have any problems to if you buy my toy and I'm painting in the color that you want. That's not a problem at all. I have a problem of the people that buys one of my toys, paint them, and then they resell them. They sell the toy with their paint. Those I have problems with because they are selling at a higher price because they paint them. They didn't ask for permission to do that. And they are getting money of work that not 100% of this work are theirs. And it's going to lower the value for the original piece often because, well, people are going to see those in on eBay and they're going to think that is a original one, and then they're going to pay a lot of money, but the money doesn't go to the artist and goes to the people that are repainting those toys. So I don't have any problems that you buy a toy, they make whatever you want with the toy, destroy, paint it, do whatever you want. But of course, please, if you paint, don't sell it as the original toy as or something similar. Paint. Don't sell it alone. Give it to someone. Do it, but not don't sell it. That's what I think. Then I can't stop people from doing it, but I can say my opinion on it. That's it. Let's see if I'm continuing. So now the eyes and the tongue are done. And the arms all also done. Now I'm going to proceed to paint the teeth of the toys. The same thing. I'm using this Vallejo model color toys, paints. Those ones. And this is the teeth on a cold white. And I will use the box, the vortex to. You can see in on. On YouTube. If you are on YouTube, you will see it. I'm using too much paint here, but that doesn't matter. All right, that's too warm here. I'm dying. I'm not sure if there is anyone watching right now. And the same thing with the teeth and a few layers, especially the this week's teas under. So very important. So I will do two layers on the teas. I think I will be making some kind of short videos from my streaming on YouTube. I will maybe take a few parts of the videos that I made from the streaming, cut it up and make shorter videos. For example, the first one about the unboxing of the globes. I can put it, and then I can make another one about the resellers, the theme about the resellers. I think then it could work as a content video. So I will try. I will try. Not sure how to do it, and how to download this video, how to use that one, because I'm filming with the camera directly streaming into the. Into YouTube, so I don't know how to do it. I should have thought that about that before. I should have created a Twitch channel. Why didn't I thought about that? Should have thought about that. Is there anyone here? Which one? On YouTube, Wonder This War 97. And interest, I have not seen one of those before. What do you mean? Which one of those? Do you mean the mixer? Hello, Jose Lacu. Are you still here? See, perfect. Let's see. I was randomly recommended this. What are we doing? I'm painting the pre-orders for Borgor. I'm not sure if you know what Borgor is, but Borgor is my here. You see, is this toy? I made this toy. This is a vinyl toy. So Fubi toy. Yep. Soft vinyl, but this is not so soft. And this is the my latest release. And this came in pieces, as you see here. I'm painting that by hand. I sold them last month as a pre-order. I got 45 pre-orders of this toy. I'm now in the last batch. These are the two toys, and the last two toys I'm painting before sending everything else. So right now I'm painting the teeth of this head, and then later today. I will put a clear coat on it, and then I will send in, put it everything together, and then I will send them to their buyers, shipping. I'm painting. I'm painting. So yep, I'm the one painting by hand. So I am the one to painting those toy. So I'm painting 45 of those big guys. It's taking a lot of time, but it's a fun thing to do. I'm not sure if you are a subscriber of the channel or if you have seen my channel before or what I'm doing. You can go on Instagram to Art Fabula Studio. I can write here. Art Fabula Studio on Instagram and see what I do. I have a few toys. A few are produced in Japan, a few are produced in Hong Kong. They are my creations. I'm the one that designed those toys. These are not characters that exist. Those are my own characters. So this is not from a movie or from everything. Yeah, those kind of things. Those are my own creations. So this is Borgor. It's called Borgor, and it has a funny name, and a long story. And then I have the other one. I have Gekkoan too. Gekkoan. Gekkoan is. I'm streaming in YouTube, so you can go to the YouTube channel. Art Fabula, I think it's Art Fabula. Art Fabula on the YouTube channel. So you can go. I think on YouTube you can see everything. You can see myself and you can see the vortex machine and everything here. So I think YouTube is a little bit better. And better sound too. So that's better. But I need to learn how to do these things because this is the first time I'm doing on YouTube and the first time I'm doing on YouTube and on Instagram. Yeah, I'm done with, you can see on Instagram, I'm done with the head. I'm done with that. Think I'm done. Let me see. There are a few things that needs to be. This vortex machine. Oh, thank you. Thank you for the subscribing. Thank you. I'm not a YouTuber. I'm just a creator, a toy creator that I am just trying to make these kind of things. So I'm not sure. I hope you like what I do, and you can suggest things for me to do. I love to get feedback. So thank you for the subscribe. It means a lot this thing, for the people that are watching on YouTube, this thing that I have here, I'm not sure if you can see. Let me zoom it. Where am I? This thing. This is a vortex, and this used it in labs. So this is the thing that I'm using to mix the paint. You can see here with this, for example. This is also a professional thing that, for example, my wife used in the lab. But there are a lot of people that are using this thing also on their painting projects. And this, I recommend this thing, this vortex, for mixing the paints, because they're perfect. I'm not sure if it's too bright. I think it's okay. So yeah. You're doing a great job. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. I'm just doing a job. I'm not sure if I'm doing a good job, but I'm doing a job. I'm just trying to make a living here with my art. With my art. Why did I say my art? I made a whole video about that I'm not considering myself an artist with my craft. Let's say that I'm doing a good job with my craft. Let's see, continue painting here. Oh no. I hope people like Borgor. This is, as I said before, this is not a toy to play with. This is a toy to get in the shelves. This is one of those kind of toys. I have, if you want to play with the toys, you have the gecko one, the other one. That is a real toy to play with. So this one has a limited movement. You can move the arms if you are careful. And you can move the head a little bit too. So it's not so possible as the gecko, for example, but this one is bigger and more massive, and the impact of it when you see in your hands, when you have it in your hands, is much, much bigger than the gecko one. You're doing a great job inspiring your creative. That's the problem. Our toy is too. I can see what you wrote here, Jay. To is to look at. What do you mean is to look at? Too beautiful, too fun, too good, too. I usually paint faster than this thing, but I reserved the last two painting on the streaming to see you, to for you to watch, to do something here. So that's why I'm so slow right now. I'm always looking at the camera on YouTube, the camera on here on Instagram, and then my computer here. So I'm always looking at me there and looking at me there and trying to see if this is working at the same time. I'm painting. So I have 345 things at the same time. Oh, it's getting late. I have 25 more minutes to be here. Then I'm done for today. Oh, do you mean so? Yes. Our toys, well, there are a lot of people that play with their toys. Especially Sofubi toys in Japan. There are people that use their toys, the Sofubi toys, as a toys. They want to pose them. They want to put them in, well, different poses. I understand that people in Japan are, well, if you don't have a very possible toy, then maybe they don't want it. But you need to understand that not everyone is making the classical Sofubi toys or art toys. There are different variations of the toy. This one is just to pose, not to pose for this. Look at this. Is this one you're putting on yourself? Yes, you can move it a little bit or so, but this is a big, this is a massive toy. Look at that. Look at this. Great. When I see this toy, when I have it in my hands, I can't believe it. And it's not because it's mine, it's because I didn't, when I designed it, I didn't thought that it was so big, but this was wow. The other one that I have, the Gigawon, this is one of my favorites. This one, this is another kind of toy. This is a real Sofubi toy. This is made in Japan. So this toy is a lot of possible. You can move it. You can move the arms. You can move everything. You can do what you want. It's a funny one, funny guy. This one is, I love this toy. This is the one that changed Art Fabula forever. This is the one that took Japan. This is a made in Japan toy, a real Sofubi. The one that took Japan, well, that made Art Fabula, well, bigger. So that's a good one. How did you come up with the idea to make your own toys? Wait, before I answer this one, I can answer the question. Okay, YouTube is a lot more convenient than Instagram. On YouTube, if you're on Instagram, go to the YouTube channel because you will see everything. You will see me. You will see everything that I have here, all the places. The camera. This thing here. Is the Instagram, my mobile phone, and then you're watching this only. You're only watching this part. You are not watching everything else. So now you see more on Instagram, on YouTube. I mean, so better on it. The other question I have: how did you come up with the idea to make your own toys? Well, this is a long question to answer, but I am a graphic designer from my background. The first background is graphic designer. In 2004, I think it was, I ended my studies of graphics designer in Spain. I'm from Spain. When I moved to Sweden, I'm living in Sweden right now, since 2006, I became a teacher. But when I was studying graphics designer in 2004 in Spain, I discovered the new trend, the new thing in the design world, and it was the art toys. It was something relatively new in Spain, or maybe in other countries too. The art toys. I discovered the Kid Robot Forum in 2004, and I became an addict from of this forum. So I posted every day. A few times a day, I became friends with, well, not friends, but so digital friends. I talked with Frank Kosik and other creators. So I was very active under the name Captain, no, Captain Beppo, Mr. Beppo, Mr. Beppo. So that was the name, Mr. Beppo. And there was people that was posting about me in the Kid Robot. I remember one person that made a post, made a thread in the Kid Robot forum about me, and I didn't understand. They were talking about me because I was so passionate about these kind of things that they thought that I. Well, they liked this passion very much. They thought it was worth to make a thread on Kid Robot about Mr. Beppo and the passion it had about art toys. There was a person, I tried to make an art toy with, I remember it was some kind of clay. It looked much like the messenger, the old messenger logo with a guy, these two balls, a smaller ball, in something like that. And I wanted to make well, some kind of what's the name? Some kind of representation of this guy, but my own self to sell to people and to for people to paint it. But I didn't have the money. Nobody had the money to create those kind of things in the time. So I forgot that thing and graphic design. I forgot to create the toys. I moved to Sweden. I began studying for to be a teacher. And right now I'm a teacher. So I'm a teacher. It's my one day job. And then I do this as a part-time job. So I'm working 150% every day. So after work and before work, I'm here in the studio making toys. So, well, the story is that in a few years ago, I got the opportunity to make a course. The opportunity to teach the students about graphics design. So I needed to relearn a few things. So I began relearning the programs, the Adobe Photoshop, the Illustrator, InDesign, everything. And then I began creating a few simple illustrations. And one of those, Eggy, where is Eggy? Eggy, where are you? Where is Eggy? I don't end here. And one of those, I like it very much. And then I thought that it would be a very good and very great art toy. And in that moment, when I saw the illustration, the illustration that I made in on Illustrator, I decided that I should pay for that one. I should make my dream from 2004 a reality in 2020, I thought it was. So I put a lot of money, I sent it to the factory, I sent it to a modeler that made it in 3D, and then I got my first art toy. And this one, Eggy, this one there was the first that started Art Fabula. So this is the Art Fabula, the first Art Fabula toy. This is a vinyl toy. It's a very, very good quality toy. I like it very much, and I have a lot of, well, good memories. I'm not selling. I have a few here, but I'm not selling them right now. I maybe will put a few in the shop soon. Maybe, not sure, but this is a great one. People love them, but I was a nobody when I sold this one, when I made this one, so it wasn't so big. And then, well, I decided to create my own art toy thing. And then I continued to create and all the other toys, as for example, Bonnie. Kinsar and Mekasar, a lot of other toys here. So this one, this Bonnie one, this what that you see both on Instagram and on Twitter. This one was the first Sofubi, the real Sofubi made in Japan. So I'm still selling those ones. I have a lot of those ones. I'm going to release more and paint them. So. The company continued until I created this one, and then it became a big thing in Japan, this one, the gecko one. And with the Borgor, with this one, then explode, everything explodes. So I don't know how it's going to end, but it's going very well. That's what I say. Let's see. That was a long question, answer to your question, Little Flower. But I missed the pre-order. Excited to see the future colorways. Yeah, don't worry about the pre-order. I mean, that's just one color. The other ones that I'm going to release are going to, of course, be more and more limited color versions, because I don't want to paint 45 more. So I will paint maybe 5, 10 of each color. I'm not sure. I will continue releasing these toys. And this is something that I say to everyone: don't worry, don't have this fear to missing out. This is not what it is. You will get one when you want, but maybe you need to. You won't get it the first time or the second time, but you will get it. And that's because I'm put it out, and then people buy fast. So, but don't worry about this. This is not going to disappear. This is going to continue. I'm going to continue to produce those three toys: Bonnie, Borgor, and the Gecko one. Those three toys I'm going to continue selling. Those are my three toys. And soon I will begin the production of my fourth and fifth toy, but that one is a secret. It's going to take a year maybe to get. I truly regret having found your profile only after the Borgor pre-sale. Do you have plans to release it? Yeah. I will continue producing this. The suggestion I have for everyone is to go to my website. I will put, wait a minute, and subscribe to the newsletter, because I am very active when I'm releasing. This is the link to the subscribing to the website. Or to subscribe, and this is the what I'm doing. When I'm releasing things, I send first an email to my followers, to the fan base there on the community, and then I release the toys, the exclusive toys, first in the closed webshop. So I have a closed workshop, a VIP webshop. So you will get the release and maybe a password, if it's exclusive color for the community, and then you can put the password on the website, and then you can access this exclusive shop. And if anything is left, then I will release it in the normal webshop for everyone to get. Sometimes I release the first version of a toy for the community, the pre-orders, the first pre-orders for the community. And then if, for example, if I have thought about releasing 20 Gecko ones, then I will put it everything on the pre-orders for the community, on the exclusive pre-orders of the community. And then if they sell, for example, 10, and then I have 10 more to sell, then I put the rest on the normal webshop. But if the 20 sells on the community, then I won't sell to anyone on the public one. So the best thing is to be on the community. It doesn't cost anything, and you will get a mail when I'm releasing thing. If you like it, go and buy it. If you don't do it anything. So it's just as simple as that. I don't going to spam you with mails, only when I'm releasing or when I'm saying something. I think it's the best way. So subscribe. He looks like an alien hiding in a ghost Halloween costume with a little backpack. Dad, you mean Eggie? Yeah, this one is a funny one. Eggie, version that I created, the original version of Eggie, was a double part toy. It was a toy that you could put the mask on, so you could see what was inside the toy. So this is a mask, and there is some kind of, I don't know what it is, inside. So my thoughts were that you could take off this mask and put it on. That's why I did this opening here, and put the backpack on it. So that was my original idea. But as you see, that doesn't work in a round toy. It's impossible because this part needs to, well, extract. It's very complicated in design. The design is very complicated. It's not works. It doesn't work. So I leave it as a toy. Yes, as a toy. It was a cool concept, but it wasn't doable. It was impossible to do it. So no, it didn't work. But well, I leave it as a mystery. What is behind this mask? What kind of toy is behind this mask? You never know. More. I want to create my own art toy also. Thanks for inspiring. And I'm on my way. Thank you very much for being here. I have a color in mind for Borgo, so I will try to be patient. Yeah, you can throw us suggestions. I have two colors in mind right now, in my mind. I will release one and another for a gallery in Japan. I will release another one, and then I will release a few small versions of the toy. So yes, that's it. Or put some kind. Yeah, well, I think I'm done. I think I'm done with this one. I hope you like it. This is the first time I'm doing. I think I'm going to concentrate me and concentrate in YouTube the next time because I get more comments and more interactions on YouTube, and you can see the bigger picture here. You can see only this part here. So I think I'm going to concentrate on YouTube from now on. Tell me if you want me to create some kind of Twitch channel. I don't know. Purple. Well, I think you will like this version that I have in mind, but it's not for sale here. I'm not going to say more than that. Well, that's it. Thank you very much for being here. Thank you very much for being on Instagram too. See you soon. Bye. One, two, and three.